Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave When I was a child, I used to wonder about God. Who is God? What is God? Where is God? I used to wonder, what is religion? What is all this? Nothing makes sense to me. I wish I could understand. What is the purpose behind aarti? What is the purpose behind prayer? No doubt, there was a great love I had for going to temples, where I would go to the neighborhood temple and I would find a lot of peace there. But I don't understand anything. It's a big puzzle and I wish I could put the pieces of the puzzle together. I believe that I'm not the only one who thinks this way. There are so many people in the world who I think the same way. Many people are puzzled. What is this all about? Is God happy when I do puja? Why is He happy when I just do puja? What is the meaning? Why do I do aarti? What is the meaning behind all this? Thankfully, my guru came along and I started understanding the purpose behind doing aarti and puja. The pieces of the puzzle started coming together very quickly, for which I will be forever grateful to God and Guru. So what we understand from scriptures is that when we do aarti, when we do puja, when we perform any ritual, when we perform any ceremony before God, it is only for one purpose, which is to fall in love with God. It's just to fall in love with God. It's for this reason that we do havan, we yajna, we do aarti, we perform aarti, we offer puja, we chant the Vishnu Sahasranam, we sing bhajans and kirtans. There's only one purpose. It's so easy. It becomes easy when a guru explains it. A guru comes down to the level of a very worldly person, a very ignorant person, and explains in very simple ways that you are doing all this, or you should be doing all this, just to fall in love with God. Saint Tulsidas says, Jab tap niyam yog nij dharma, shruti sambhav nana shubh karma, gyan daya dav tirath majjan, jahalagi dharma kahe shruti sajjan, Agam Nigam Puran Aneka Padhe Sune Kar Phal Prabhu Eka Tav Pad Pankaj Priti Nirantar Yah Sab Sadhan Kar Yah Phal Sundar Jap Tap Telling on the beads Hare Ram Hare Ram Ram Ram, Ram Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Jap, tapascharya, hanging upside down, living only on leaves and fruits, roots, living only on water, practicing austere penance, tapascharya, daan, giving charity, majjan, bathing in the holy rivers like Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati. All this, says Saint Tulsidas, when you do all this, when you engage in all these actions, then the end result should be that you have fallen in love with God. Why else should you be doing jap? Why else should you be bathing in the holy river? Why else should you be going on a pilgrimage? So the consequence of doing all this is that we have fallen in love with God. And if we don't fall in love with God, then it means that we are merely paying lip service. When we do puja, when any puja is done, the priest says at the end, "My Lord, I am ignorant. I don't know any devotion. Please forgive me." So forgiveness is asked from God. "I don't know any devotion. I don't know how to do anything. I am relying on your grace. Please forgive me, because you are all forgiven." So the puja is not just a hollow ritual. It is an act of love. It's a love offering to God. And it should be conducted in such a way. The mind must be on God as the hands perform the puja. When we chant bhajans and kirtans, it should not be just because we love music. Then there would be no difference between singing for God, a song dedicated to God, and a song dedicated to a person of the world. When we sing bhajans and kirtans, the purpose behind doing bhajan and kirtan should be to think about God lovingly, to fall in love with God. The purpose behind going on the pilgrimage, again, is the same. In the olden days, people used to go to Tirth. They used to go on pilgrimage because many saints used to live there. And in fact, only saints used to live in holy places. So when you would go there, you would find many saints there, true lovers of God. And through their association, we would go to do pilgrimage, we would gain a lot of knowledge of God. Pure knowledge, not bookish knowledge, pure knowledge of God. And then we would find ourselves through the saintly association that we are also falling in love with God. That was in the days of old. Nowadays it's not like that. It's not that only saintly souls live in holy places. But when we go to these holy places, we ought to do our best to think about God. Jagatguru Sri Kripaluji Maharaj used to say, when you go to Vrindavan, you should be so much in love with Sri Krishna that even before entering Vrindavan, you should lose consciousness, thinking, "I am going to enter Vrindavan. I am going to enter the place where my Lord placed his tiny little lotus feet. This is the place where he crawled. This is the same ground. This is where he walked. This is where he grazed the cows. This is where he performed the maharas. This is the same Yamuna in which he did battle with serpent Kaliya." Just thinking about all this should make you lose your body consciousness. He used to say, if you're not at that point yet, then just go to Vrindavan in your mind. Don't go physically. Because if you go there physically and you're not in love with Sri Krishna, you're going to see a lot of filth, you're going to see a lot of conniving people, you're going to be very annoyed with certain people, you're going to find the water unacceptable, you're going to find everything wrong with Vrindavan. The purpose behind going to a holy place is that we feel the presence of God, like the gopis. Jitta dekhun shyam vahi hai. Wherever I look, says the gopi, I see Shyam Sundar. I see my dark complexion glowing. So there is most certainly a reason why we do puja, why we do havan, why we chant the names of God, why we go on a pilgrimage. why we do jap, why we do tapascharya or penance. Mind you, in the present age, in Kali Yuga, the only prescribed method is chanting of the holy name. Just by singing the name of God, just by chanting the name of Sri Hari, we can reach Him. We can fall in love with Him. Just by chanting His name, we can reach Him. We can fall in love with Him. Kali Yug Keval Naam Adhara Sumiri Sumiri Nar Utrahi Paara Ehi Kali Kaal Na Sadhan Duja Jog Na Jap Tap Vrat Makh Pooja. Ramcharit Manas. Skand Puran says similarly, Hare Namaiva 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 Mama Jeevanam Kalau Nastyeva 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 Gatiranyatha. In Kali Yuga, there is no other method of reaching God except by chanting the holy name. Chanting of the holy name is a practice that is recommended by the eternal Vedas. The Vedas which have no beginning. The Vedas which have sprung forth from the natural breath of God. Nishrasitamasya Vedaha. Vedas which are untouched by any fault, by any error. There is no error in the Vedas, the only error is in our understanding. Because these Vedas are not touched by any human intelligence.